people, 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 people. Que pasa, sa pase, what they do? Now, people, it seems like the Popo and the minibus men are back at it once again, one more again. And people, like me say, sometimes I get these videos, sometimes they are new, sometimes they are a bit older. However, the message is still the same. The message is to make people learn from what is going on in Jamaica, and we are speaking as it pertains to the Popo and as it pertains to the drivers of public passenger vehicle. So people, in this case, we see it happening once again. I like me say, me can't verify or validate that this video is brand new. However, the message is very important. So in this case, we see that the Popo pull over a minibus, and the Popo is claiming that this person who is supposed to be the conductor, he was not in uniform. However, the driver of that said bus is claiming that he was not the conductor. The driver claimed that he is conducting and driving the bus. He is a one-man show, and people, you know that story from the start sounds ridiculous, because it seems like the Popo was preying the bus, and it seems like the Popo decided that they want to pull them over. And people, just to make it very clear, this is my disclaimer. I was not there. I cannot say without a shadow of a doubt that that was what happened. However, take a look to the video, and people, you understand that this is YouTube, and you know the policy and rate and lele. So therefore, this is an edited version. So sometimes you might see the video point up in the sky. It is for a reason. Don't start to BCH, because you understand it is only common sense. So anyway, take a listen, take a look, and then I'll give my piece.
Big man, look up, woman.
Stop resisting the police, sir!
Jesus!
Come on, man!
Stop resisting the police!
Me a blow shot! Yo, well,
watch your man, I'm going to jump on him now, because that's sick, man. Watch your man, I'm going to jump on him.
Come on,
tell him, man, check.
Come on, tell him, man, check.
Come on, tell him, man,
check. Me a blow shot.
People, don't get it twisted, don't get it misconstrued. The popo in Jamaica cannot be compared to the popo in a first world country, because Jamaica is a very hostile place. There is no respect for the popo. Likewise, it seems like the popo has no respect for the citizens of Jamaica. So people, second thing, based on what the popo is saying, or based on my impression of this video, it seems like the popo are claiming that this man was conducting upon the bus. And obviously, we see that he did not have on any type of uniform. So therefore, they could not have identified that he is indeed a bus conductor. And based on what is going on in Jamaica with all the CRIME, we understand from that perspective. We also have to look at what is going on. People, you have to understand that whenever you are stopped by the popo, the rules as it pertains to resisting arrest is very strange. It depends on how you look upon it, because people, like we say, once the police are trying to put on that handcuff on your hand and you basically shake up, it can be deemed as you resisting arrest, when basically you are just fighting for your rights. Because if you feel that you are not doing anything wrong, the first thing that you are going to do, you are going to stand up for your rights. Because if you feel so you're not supposed to be arrested in the first place, then you are going to resist. So my point is that it is just a human being standing up for what they believe in, and that is their rights. We are talking about human rights, we are talking about civil rights. And next thing that I realize with a lot of these popo in Jamaica, if one see the next one doing something wrong, they are going to defend it regardless of how wrong it is, if it is even DEAD wrong. So in this case, like me tell you, so the people them kind of hostile. So therefore, the popo is not working under regular circumstance, they are working under extreme circumstance. However, in this video, we saw clearly where the popo had his knee in this man's chest after he was already down, after he had the handcuff on his hand, and the man was telling him that he cannot breathe. And people, we saw that the popo made no effort to come off of the man's chest. So to the average person viewing this video, it seems like this popo would rather to show and prove, to prove his point, than to make this man live. He would rather to see him die just to prove his point. Now people, we talk about when something is getting bad and then you make it escalate to a worse degree, that means you make a bad situation get worse. And we see that is exactly what happened in this case, because we saw that the man almost house pass out. And people like me say, me no know this person. I don't know if he's asthmatic. I don't know if he has breathing problem. I don't know if he has bronchitis or rete and lele. However, you saw that the police allow him to pass out. And people understand that in Jamaica, when it comes to the paramedics, when you dial 119, nobody shows up. You are going to wait forever. You are going to DIE upon the spot, point blank and period. So my point is that it started with the man kind of seemed like he was resisting A-R-R-E-S-T because he thought that he was standing up for his right. However, we saw that the popo allowed it to escalate out of control, where the man basically seems like he almost passed out. Now, people like me say, it is just my views, it is just my opinion, it is not the gospel. Your views and opinion can be respectfully different from mine. But let me know what you think in the comment section. Bless up.